Moin and hello, I'm Lothar from May Games, and this video is about troubleshooting issues with the EOS Blueprints project. As of Unreal Engine 5.0.2, the official online subsystem EOS is still beta and very buggy. If you encounter any bugs or have trouble setting up the artifact in the Epic Games developer portal, this video is here to help. Now, we are diving right into the action. First of all, I will provide some generic advice when troubleshooting EOS issues. We need to use the mode standalone game when testing. Always. The reason for this is that accessing the online subsystem EOS is not possible if you run the game within the editor. Login will fail there. Also, server travel will fail. We have to use standalone game or run the game separately. Actually, the same is true if we are using the online subsystem Steam. The next generic advice is, we need to double check that the artifact settings from the Epic Games developer portal are copied correctly. I cannot stress this enough. I've received a lot of requests for help where in the end it turned out that the artifact settings were incorrect. It would have been a lot easier if Epic Games simply generated one JSON string containing all values that needed to be copied. But instead, we have to copy all the values to their corresponding setting fields, and the order is different, and don't use the EOS application ID when setting up Unreal Engine. The next generic advice is, we should check the log file for error messages. On Windows, the log files are located in the saved folder, subfolder logs. Usually, there are two different log files which are created. One is for the Unreal Editor, and one is for the standalone game. The editor log is usually larger, so we open the smaller standalone game log. Within the log file, we can search for error or fail to analyze the context. On macOS, the log files are located in the library logs subfolder of the home directory. Okay, these are the general hints. Next, we are considering specific issues. A crash may occur when opening the EOS project. And by that I mean just when starting Unreal Engine. I've mentioned this in the tutorial, but some people may have skipped this part. The crash usually occurs because the artifact setup is missing. As a workaround, we need to open the default engine INI file, go to section Online Subsystem EOS, and set Be Enabled to False. Now, the project can be opened again and we need to set up the EOS plugin settings. Afterwards, we can re-enable the online subsystem EOS and there will be no more crash. The next specific issue is login may fail even before the account portal login screen is shown. The fail blueprint node may not even be run in this case. Now, I'm assuming that we already verified that the artifact settings are correct. We should check that we entered account portal in the correct parameter field of the login blueprint node. In the Advanced Sessions plugin for Unreal Engine 5, the auth type parameter is hidden by default. Do not enter account portal in the wrong field. Instead, show the auth type parameter by clicking on the small arrow and enter account portal there. If this was not the cause for the login failure, then we should also verify the basic artifact setup. This is important for all users of EOS, even without Unreal Engine. We go to the Epic Games developer portal, click on Epic Account Services, Permissions, and verify online presence and friends are selected. This may be required for you in order to experiment with OSS EOS. But the most important part is you need to go to Linked Clients and verify the client is selected. Last but not least, check the log file as it will also contain messages reported by EOS, for example, if authentication simply failed. Okay, next specific issue. Assuming the login works fine, what to do if creating a session fails? First, we should still verify the artifact setup. There might be an invalid ID that does not affect the login but leads to a failure when creating a session. Assuming the artifact setup is correct, this issue is most likely caused by missing permissions in the client policy. Go to the Epic Games Developer Portal, Product Settings, Clients, Client Policies, and click on Update Policy. If you are using Unreal Engine 4.27.2, you need to use the client policy type peer-to-peer. For Unreal Engine 5.0.2, some more work is required. And this will be explained in the next section. Now, the worst of all specific issues. Creating a session may cause an Unreal Engine crash. This issue is most likely caused by missing permissions in the client policy. So go to the Epic Games Developer Portal, Product Settings, Clients, Client Policies, and click on Update Policy. If you're using Unreal Engine 5.0.2, at this time it is not sufficient to use the client policy type peer-to-peer. This is because the matchmaking permission Manage Players is required in Unreal Engine 5.0.2, but it is missing in the peer-to-peer policy type. Hopefully, this will be fixed by Epic Games, since the semantics of setting peer-to-peer should be totally fine for our project. But for now, we need to remember, or write down, all settings done by peer-to-peer. And then set client policy type custom, check user required, and copy all settings we wrote down from the peer-to-peer policy type. And then we go to the section matchmaking and add the manage players permission. That's a lot of fun. Thank you, Epic Games. All this is worth the effort because it will fix the crash. The next specific issue is that joining a session may lead to a blank screen. The cause of this issue is usually that you are joining a session which is no longer valid. In the EOS Blueprints tutorial, sessions are not manually destroyed because this used to be broken. This means that if you create a session and then terminate the game, the session will still be lingering for some time. If you try to join this lingering session, this will usually lead to a blank screen on the client. For production use, you need to properly destroy sessions. As a workaround for the EOS Blueprints project, just wait for a few minutes until the lingering session is destroyed by the Epic Games backend. On to the next specific issue. Joining a session may fail. If you are using EOS Plus, for example with Steam login, make sure that you are using session filters and that they are set up correctly. EOS Plus sessions cannot be browsed without a filter. In all other cases, verify that the session was successfully created. Go to the Epic Games Developer Portal, Game Services, Matchmaking, and list all sessions. If no session exists, this is probably an access right issue. So go back to the troubleshooting part about creating sessions. And also, we need two different standalone games on two different systems with two different accounts if we want to test both client and server. And these are all the issues for now. Let me know if you still have trouble setting up EOS with Unreal Engine. Have a wonderful time!